That's a different thing altogether. Well, is there anything more that you'd like to read?
Would you guys like me to read anymore, or are there any questions?
Any questions?
I saw one nod.
All right. I think what we can do is, I think since you had four excerpts in mind, you can end with a fourth excerpt.
Okay. With Armand, and I think this is something that a lot of women deal with.
So Armand comes back into the picture.
Armand comes back into the picture. Oh, I gave it away. But he comes back into the picture. So they've taken a little vacation to the Taj Mahal. Now, remember, these are NRIs. We like doing things like this. So they go to Agra to see the Taj Mahal, and they're having dinner at the end of the day. So Lila's heels clicked gently on the marble floor. She walked through the lobby, Armand already ahead of her at the restaurant, saving the table for dinner. Nestled in the corner of the ground floor, she found her way to the Baghe Bahar restaurant. Through the relatively empty at that time of night, a few foreigners at the bar watched her walk past them toward the outdoor terrace. Armand sat with his back to the entrance. Two glasses of wine were on the table. He held up a menu in one hand and began to read it. Lila stopped 10 feet away. She watched his profile, her presence not yet noticed. He leaned back in his chair, his muscular shoulders relaxed. A faint shadow of the day's growth covered his strong jaw. His eyes stared ahead, straight ahead, lost in his thoughts, a finger tapping absently on the table. She smiled and walked forward. How did I get so lucky? She touched his shoulder when she reached him. Nudged out of his daydream, he started to turn his head towards her. Lila, what took you so... His eyes stared at her bare stomach through the sheer black chiffon. Small raven beads glittered in the candlelight, competing with the gemstone ring in her belly button. His eyes moved up. The halter portion of her blouse hid under her hair. Her shoulders and back appeared nude. She's wearing a sari, by the way. Just background. Lila, his eyes lit up. You look so... He whistled and pushed out his chair. Hot. He pulled her in for a kiss, stepped back and pulled a chair for her, his eyes glued to her body. He sat down and narrowed his eyes. I love that naked blouse. Yeah? Lila touched her neck. It's the latest fashion, she teased. No, sweetheart, he smiled back and winked. That blouse better just be for me. So possessive, Lila laughed. Yes, my John, you are my reason for this partial nudity. He grinned and raised a brow. That sari looks familiar. He had bought it for her in a separate trip. The waiter arrived. At that moment, Armand looked up, catching the young man's eyes move to Lila's direction. He cleared his throat, regaining the server's attention. Do you trust me, or do you want to have a glance at the menu? He asked Lila. She wrinkled her nose. Anything's fine. The waiter took their order and left. Armand held her hand under the table. What a nice surprise to see you wearing this sari. He squeezed her palm. Did Vanita approve this personal modeling for me? Shh, don't tell her, Lila laughed. Nestled outside, the restaurant overlooked the darkened gardens and glittering pool. A cloudless sky and full moon hung over them, and the air's soft breeze gently played with Lila's hair. Birds and crickets competed with the music that played inside the hotel. They sat in silence while Lila's fingers caressed the palm of his hand. So how's work in Singapore, babe? Armand smiled, amazing. He took a deep breath and turned his hand to interlace their fingers. The company is heavily focused on clean tech and building a sustainable business model around it. He grinned. I hit the lottery with these projects. The companies I'm overseeing are so far ahead of the curve. The potential is amazing. Just to be involved in this progress, it's a huge responsibility. Lila watched his expression brighten when he spoke of the recognition from his peers and the excitement about the business possibilities. She could see how much he loved his job. Initially, the partners were thinking of divvying up the Asian investment across the team, but it looks like everyone is confident that I can handle them for now. He smiled. It's going to be a challenge, but it feels good to have their support. Lila rubbed his thigh under the table. When I get back to the States, we're going to have to figure something out. She winked. It's time to put an end to the distance between us. Armand leaned forward to kiss her lips. I agree, he whispered. The waiter returned with their food platters, displaying them in a decorative arrangement on the table. Do you need anything else? He asked, his eyes again flicking repeatedly toward Lila. Armand shook his head and watched the waiter leave. What was that guy staring at? He didn't hide his annoyance. Babe, I think that blouse might be too sexy for the general public to handle. He gave her a small smile. Or maybe he recognizes me from one of the ads I've done. Lila took a bite of his spicy Manchurian. How's that going these days? Are you having fun? Lila spooned some ginger chili mixed vegetables onto her plate. It's a mixed bag. She had shared her earlier disappointment with the frying pan ads and her excitement about seeing her work in the mall. It's different. She wished for the same enthusiasm that Armand had for his work. Anyway, Manish is pushing me, but wants me to prove myself first. I have no idea what's going to happen next. Armand touched her leg. These people would have to be blind not to want you. He took a sip of his wine. His eyes wandered over her sari, especially when you look like this. Lila laughed. Are you undressing me with your pervy eyes? Let's eat faster so I don't have to do it in my head, he teased. Lila smiled and took another bite of her food. Her phone rang in her purse. She frowned, curious about the caller. I'm so sorry, let me just turn this off. She reached in her clutch for the handset. When she saw the caller ID, her frown deepened. Why is Manish calling me now? Also from the agency. She looked up at Arman, her face asking forgiveness. He nodded, go ahead, take it. Manish, yeah, hi, what's up? She listened, what? No, I can't hear you. I think the reception's bad. Okay, yeah, I'll just, hold on a second. She touched Arman's face with one hand and whispered, I'll be right back. I'm so sorry, just one second. She walked inside the restaurant doors. The waiter returned to the table to refill their water glasses. Sir, anything more? No, thank you. Arman closed his eyes, his face tilted up to the sky. Sir? He looked up towards the waiter, yes. His irritation hadn't faded from the man's earlier wandering eyes. Sir, you are with Sheetal? He wobbled his head sideways and smiled. From the television serial. Sheetal? Arman stared at him unblinking. Sheetal Saeed? He smiled, proud of his celebrity discovery. She is not your wife, no? Sheetal, she is the same actress only. Her magazine just yesterday came with the bikini. He grinned, looked to Arman for the man-to-man understanding. Very nice. Arman clenched his jaw. You are a lucky man. Sheetal is very famous, very beautiful. In the magazine, she's very nice. He grinned. She, thank you. Arman's voice thundered to the quiet night. He stared at the waiter, his back muscles tensed, the veins in his neck protruding under his collar. Please go, now. Send another server to handle this table. He glared, watching the defeated man retreat. His hand tightened around his glass, blood pounding in his temples.
I'd be happy to do it post the event. Once again, Tulika, thank you so much for coming here and for sharing wonderful insights about your book, reading all those excerpts to the audience and telling us so much more about Lila the character.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much. Once again, an encouraging all the best for all your upcoming endeavors. Thank you very
much.
Have a good evening.